Hello and welcome to the Classical Club. I call today's program A Season, Patriotism Times Two, and A Great Pianist. We'll start off with a piece that's the season that I was talking about. The season, specifically, is autumn. Virgil Thompson, an American composer, wrote this piece. It's a little short piece, four little sections: Salute to the Wind, Dialogue, Love Scene, and Promenade, or Promenade. Written for an interesting group of instruments, harp, strings, and percussion. Virgil Thompson was a very well-known figure in American classical music in the 20th century, probably better known for his music writing than for his actual composing of music. He wrote about music a lot in various books, and he reviewed music in newspapers and magazines, and he was pretty much known as the outstanding music critic of classical music in America for a long period of time. He also wrote music, and that's what we're going to hear today. This piece called Autumn is played by the St. Louis Symphony Orchestra with Leonard Slatkin conducting. So let's get started. I'll just turn around and start the machine here. Having a glitch in the machine there for some reason. Let me try this again. I apologize for this delay. You can't force stubborn machines to work. You just have to be patient. Thank you. That was called Salute to the Wind. This one's called Dialogue. This is my cat, Molly. Molly. Say hello, Molly. Yeah. Here's the third section of this piece. It's called Love Scene.
Thank you.
And now the fourth part, which is called Promenade. There it is, Autumn, by Virgil Thompson. Virgil Thompson wrote that piece, by the way, as a commission for the harp player who isn't on this recording, but that's who wrote the piece for, who is the most famous, probably the only really well-known harp player in the first two-thirds of the 20th century, Nicanor Zabaleta, who was a Spanish fellow. And it's unusual because every time you go to see an orchestra, and this has been the case for many years, and if they have a harp being used in a piece, it's almost inevitably a woman playing the harp. It seems to have been an instrument for females. And yet, the outstanding harpist of the first part of the 20th century was a male, Nicanor Zabaleta. Anyway, here's a piece that has to do with patriotism. Sibelius wrote it. Jean Sibelius was a Finnish composer. In 1900, he wrote this piece, which was basically considered to be a sort of an homage to his country called Finlandia. It became so popular and was so well known that he became immediately the most famous Finnish composer and remains the most famous Finnish composer to this day. The theme of Finlandia was used as the national anthem of Finland. And if you are a churchgoer, you may have heard it set as a hymn, because many hymnals have the Finlandia theme in it. But there's more to the piece Finlandia than just that one theme, which they used for the national anthem. It's quite a dramatic piece. It lasts about 8 minutes, 8.5 minutes. And it doesn't get into that theme till about two-thirds of the way through. But then it's very welcome when we hear that. So here it is. The theme, well, not the theme, but Finlandia, Opus 26, by Jean Sibelius. This is played by Arthur Fiedler and the Boston Pops. Again, I apologize for my stubborn tape disc player here. We'll probably get it going in a minute, though. There we go.
Thank you.
finally comes the famous melody. Finlandia by Sibelius. Here's another piece that I'm, for today's purposes, classifying as patriotic. It's called the Russian Easter Festival Overture. I've never been able to determine exactly what it has to do with Easter, but presumably that was in the mind of the composer, Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov. We do know that he dedicated the piece to the memory of two famous composers who had already passed away, contemporaries of his, but who died young, Modest Mussorgsky, Alexander Borodin. They, along with Rimsky-Korsakov and Tchaikovsky and a few other people, made up a great collection of wonderful Russian composers in the second half of the 19th century. Probably the best of them is Rimsky-Korsakov. The best of them are Rimsky-Korsakov and Tchaikovsky, but the others are superb. Anyway, we'll hear this Russian Easter Festival Overture. It's a very energetic piece, a very good piece. It's not played often enough, to my taste. You don't hear it on the radio as often as you hear other pieces by Rimsky-Korsakov. But here it is, the Russian Easter Festival Overture, played for us by the Philadelphia Orchestra, and it's conducted by a Russian who left Russia at a young age and lived his entire career, most of his entire career, in the United States, Eugene Ormandy, the great conductor. Again, I apologize for the technical difficulties. Here we go. The Russian Easter Festival Overture.
Thank you. Thank you.
Russian Easter Festival Overture by Rimsky-Korsakov. Here's a piece now that I chose because it's played by a great piano player. It's also a great piece. César Franck was a composer who lived in the last two-thirds, really, of the 19th century, a French composer, an organist, very well known. Didn't have a huge output as a composer, but he had a huge output of really good pieces as a composer. Many of his pieces are played frequently, despite the fact that he didn't write that many. One of them is this piece called Symphonic Variations. He made up a little melody, and then he did variations on it for piano with orchestra. It's not a piano concerto, exactly, or it isn't a piano concerto at all, but it's a very interesting form. The pianist, Walter Gieseking, was a German fellow who was born in France and had a large part of his career in France. And during his career, I think he died in 1956, and he wasn't that old then. He was only about 60 years old. During his career, he became especially well known for his ability of the French composers, especially Debussy, but also Ravel and Franck. Here. So we get to hear an example of this. This is a recording, by the way, that's made in 1932. Think about that. Almost a century ago. It sounds wonderful. They had pretty much figured out how to do recordings by 1932, at least recordings of solo instruments like the piano. They could put a microphone here and another microphone for the orchestra. Anyway, it sounds really good. So here's Walter Gieseking playing the Symphonic Variations by César Franck. That's spelled F-R-A-N-C-K. Feed my cats.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Symphonic Variations by César Franck, as played there by the wonderful German pianist Walter Gieseking. And I'm afraid that's all that we have time for today. I'll be back next time with some more music. In fact, I've got a song, a march, an overture, a concerto, and a waltz for you next time. So I look forward to that, and I hope you have a nice rest of whatever part of the day it is for you. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.